Good morning, students. In yesterday class, we study comparative study of solution, colloid and suspension by particle size, Tyndall effect and Browninian moment and their stability. Today, we discuss how can we separate the component of a mixture. Students, in your earlier classes, you study how can we separate a different component of a mixture. And in our day-to-day life, we also separate the different component of a mixer. For example, in a grain, weight, gram, bajra, if there are any stone particles are present, then we remove by hand picking. After then we get the flour and we take for making chapati for that flour. And in everyday life, when making tea, we remove the tea leaves by that process known as sieving. So we discuss in detail some techniques how can we separate the component of a mixer. So at first I take one by one. First technique for separation of the component of a mixer is by hand picking. So in our daily life we remove the large stones by removing by hand from the grains or other particles, means they are larger size, we can remove by hand picking. Other one, by sieving, we can remove tea leaves from the tea, and we can remove light particle by using our water have, rain water and other water, if any present small particles, sand and other particle, we can remove by our clothes using sieving. Third one, by filtration, we use the filter paper. In yesterday class, we separate out chalk powder in water, sand in water, means that is suspension particle, we can remove by filtration technique. Other one, by evaporation. If two liquids, one is volatile, other is non-volatile. Volatile and non-volatile means salt in water, sugar in water, like ink in water, that is separate by evaporation. So when we heat the substance, then the water is evaporate and non-volatile solute remaining in that, like salt. But this process is not good. Reason behind, because by impurity also remaining on that component, if there is impurity remaining. Other one process are centrifugation, separating funnel, sublimation, chromatography, distillation, fractional distillation and crystallization. These different techniques we study one by one in detail. Students, first we study what is evaporation. By showing you an activity, that is how can ink separate from the water. Students, I want to separate the ink in water because this is a mixer I placed on this watch glass, ink in water, and this is a beaker and beaker placed the water bath. Because when the water vapor heating, that the ink, this ink have water molecule and that water molecule evaporate, this blue ink have a mixtures of dyes. So that is a, we can separate water in this. So this process known as evaporation. We can separate by this technique salt in water. And formation of a raw salt from the salty lake or from sea water, we can use this technique, that is evaporation. But in this technique, there are one disadvantage. We can't get pure substance, because impurity remaining in the ink, remaining on the substance on this watch glass. In similar way, we get the sodium chloride rock salt by this process. And Mahatma Gandhi, that is, you know, Dandi March, that started 12 March 1932, 6 April 1930. On that, that time, British government on ban on the salt. So we will prepare that raw salt by this technique, that is evaporation. But that salt have some impurity that we further can remove out by different techniques. So this technique we heating the water, then the water vapor evaporate. What happen if we direct heat without the water glass? Then the substance is decompose, because it have a different nature, and that substance will decompose by direct heating. So it is heating by the water vapors. So this technique known as evaporation. Friends, now we separate the milk by the technique known as centrifugation. So this machine is a centrifugal machine, and this have four test tube. We can separate by this, we separate cream from milk by this technique, and I put the milk in test tube, and I want to separate out the cream. This milk I placed on this test tube that is inside the centrifugation machine. Other test tube also I fill the milk and want to remove that is fat in water, because we know milk is a colloidal solid, and that is type of emulsion. So these are four test tube I fill the milk, and further we start this process, and I put this one and start this process. So this is a centrifugation. By in this centrifugation, the process is very fast. The test tube are rotating. I can show this test tube view. They are moving in this way, very faster. And by this, the denser particle settle down at the bottom and lighter come on the surface. The milk is separate out from the means fat come on the surface, denser particle settle down at the bottom, and the milk come on the surface. This technique known as centrifugation. We see what happen in this, and we find, because fat particles, you can see the separate layer upper side slightly difference, because there is a less lower fat in this, but slightly comparatively separate layer formation, because this is upper side, you can see clearly that is fat is upper, means cream. This one is cream from milk, we can separate in this way cream from milk. This technique used in milk industry, means the milkmen, they at first remove the milk, toned, double toned and full cream, the milk, the person, they remove by this way. So we get that type milk, toned milk, full cream and different types of milk. Hence, our new technique is using separating funnel. This one is separating funnel. We can separate these by using this funnel immiscible liquids. What do you mean by immiscible liquids? Those liquid make separate layer. So at first we separate the oil and water. Students, you know this one is mustard oil, and we mix this mustard oil and water. So this one is a mustard oil. I take small, and this water, you can see this one is a mixture. Oil is light, water, oil come on the surface. So if I remove this in this way, oil in water, separate layer formation. So students, how we remove? We can remove by using this separating funnel. This separating funnel, this separating funnel we use to move in this. So this one is a mixer. In this mixer, you can clearly see upper side is oil particle and lower side is water. And it is not completely soluble, separate layer formation. Mustard oil in water. So how can we separate? We can separate in this way because we are can seeing there is slightly less separate layer. So when I open this, then the water molecule, water is separate out. Oil remaining in this, only water particles are separate. So this is separation technique using separating funnel two immiscible liquids. This is way. So water is separate out, oil remaining in the separating funnel. So by this technique, we can use oil and water. I can show you another example, carbon tetrachloride and water. Students, another mixer I take, carbon tetrachloride. You can see the color of carbon tetrachloride. That is colorless, like liquid. And I mix some water in this. Then you can see different layer, that is denser and that one lighter. Water and this carbon tetrachloride, different layer. So students, how can we find out this is carbon tetrachloride and water? I can mix some iodine in this. Then you can clearly observe, I make mixer iodine in this chemical. This one is iodine, I mix. So when I dissolve in this, you can see the difference in the iodine solubility. Two separate layer formation. So lower side, that is this color, is carbon tetrachloride, because carbon tetrachloride is denser, more density, and water is lighter, it come on the surface. So we want separate these mixer by using separating funnel. Why? Because this one is a immiscible liquid. Immiscible means those liquid, they are not mixed to each other, separate layer formation. They can separate using separating funnel. So now we will separate this also. Again, using separating funnel. Students, you can clearly see that is different color. That one is carbon tetrachloride and upper side is water, because water is lighter there, carbon tetrachloride is denser. When I open this, so this one chemical is separate out. So this technique known as separation. Okay. Hence, I am showing you another example. This earlier example, carbon tetrachloride and water, I mix iodine. So iodine have different color in both the solution. Carbon tetrachloride more denser, so settle down at the bottom. This separate layer formation, clearly we can remove by separating funnel. I am showing you another example of benzene. That one, students, you can see the color of benzene also. This one is a colorless substance, this. Colorless, benzene also colorless, and I want to mix benzene in water. Then you can see the water and benzene also not soluble, separate layer formation in this. So such types I mix water and benzene. So students, in this way, you can see that is to separate layer formation, and this in this way we can separate those liquids, they have separate layer, immiscible liquid, because they are not mixed. Separate layer formation, they can separate using separating funnel, difference of the density. The principle behind of this difference of density, you can see water and oil separate layer, benzene and water separate layer, carbon tetrachloride and water separate layer, mix iodine. So iodine have different color. So these techniques using separating funnel, they have different density and immiscible liquids.
Okay.
Sublimation. In sublimation process, those substance change direct solid to gas, that known as sublime substance. And sublime substance can be separate by heating. That is sublimation process. Some example of sublime substance: ammonium chloride, camphor, naphthalene, anthracene, iodine, and solid carbon dioxide. So these substance can separate by sublimation. Students, I am showing you example, that is ammonium chloride. Ammonium chloride is a white crystal, this type salt. Other one, sodium chloride, means that is namak or table salt. That one, sodium chloride. I mix these two salts into each other, ammonium chloride and sodium chloride. These two salts, when I mix and I want to separate these components, because one is ammonium, other one sodium chloride. So this process, I placed a inverted funnel, that I already plug a cotton plug, means to not remove out the gaseous, and it placed in this way, all salts can cover this funnel, and setting on this tripod stand and heating, directly heat on this funnel. Students, after some times we can see the white fumes release out, white fumes of, that is ammonium chloride, and that ammonium chloride on the wall of the funnel settle down. You can see later, after 2-3 minutes. Students, you can see white crystals deposit on the surface. You can see the fumes. These are ammonium chloride, and that is deposit on the surface of the funnel. So this substance, that is vapor remove out, this one is ammonium chloride, and this ammonium chloride deposits submitted on this side of the funnel. So in this way, this process known as sublimation, we can separate the substance, sublime substance only, because they change direct solid to gaseous state. Students, now we see the applications of different terms. First, I show you the evaporation. By this evaporation, we separate the ink from water. But in this ink is made by different dyes. So what these techniques we can apply in our daily life? This technique we apply to separate out raw material, raw salt from marine lakes and from the coastal area of the sea. By these techniques we prepare salt, raw salt, rock salt, namak. And the other application is centrifugation. Student, centrifugation, we can separate cream from milk. So we can apply in our daily life these different applications. First application, used in diagnostic laboratory for blood and urine test. Students, you know, we have to different test for blood, because in our body urea formation, and that urea, and if any person's kidney is not working properly, so we have to separate that urea from blood. The blood and urine test, why we use applying the centrifugation, the difference of the density. The principle behind that is blood and urea, urine have different density, they can separate out by centrifugation techniques. Other one, used in dairies and home to separate butter from cream. Students, with this cream further convert into butter, we use these techniques in dairy products in our home also. That process known as churning, in our daily life, in our homes. That is butter from cream. Third one is very, very essential in our daily life, used in washing machines. In washing machines, we use this process to remove out, squeeze out wet from wet clothes water. So we want to dry our clothes in rainy seasons, or in when there no proper sun on sunlight is not available, we use the washing machines. The washing machines also work in that same principle, that is centrifugation. They remove out all the waters. So these techniques very important. You have to learn diagnostic laboratories in dairy products, in homes and in washing machines. Other one, that is a further application of separating funnel. This separating funnel, how can we separate? We separate immiscible liquids like this, immiscible liquid. This liquid is carbon tetrachloride and water, separate layer formation. They easily separate by using separating funnel. Oil and water, this one oil and water also separate by using separating funnel. So that industry, in industry, how can we apply these techniques? We industry apply to remove iron from its ore. Because students, you study in 10th or 12th class, how can we extract iron? Iron is a lighter in ore from in a blast furnace. In that furnace, there is a molten slag. Slag means that are when we wash our clothes, like the leathers and the dirt particles are removed out. In similar way, that is slag. And that is lower density, it's float over and molten iron lower side. They separate by this technique, the centrifugation techniques. So we apply in industry iron from iron ore. So you learn these applications and further apply in our daily life. Tomorrow we will study the next technique. That one is chromatography, distillation, fractional distillation, and crystallization. These four techniques we study tomorrow. And by sublimation, you know, the separate only those substances, they are sublime. They change directly solid to gaseous state. So study in your NCERT book 2-3 times and write in your notebook. If you have any problem, then write on comment box. And we will solve the problem in next lesson, in next video. And thank you. And share the needy students. Thank you. Have a nice day.